students, welcome to my channel PM Biology. Today we will talk about Mendel's laws of inheritance. In the previous videos we have talked about Mendelian crosses, that is monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. So here, on the basis of that, two experiments, that is monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross, these are the three laws made by Mendel, known as Mendel's laws of inheritance. So if you haven't watched the previous videos, which are Mendelian crosses, monohybrid and dihybrid crosses, please watch them, because on that basis itself these three laws are made. So watch previous videos, and the link of those videos is given in the description. Now let's start the Mendel's laws of inheritance. The Mendel's law of inheritance says, the first law says law of dominance. It is known as law of dominance. It is the first law of inheritance. In a cross between two organisms, pure for any pair of contrasting characters, the character that appears in F1 generation is called dominant, and the one which is suppressed is called recessive. So the cross of Mendelian, that is monohybrid cross, he saw that the organisms for any pair of contrasting characters, the character which is appearing in first generation or first filial generation called F1 generation is a dominant one, and the one which gets suppressed here, which is not appearing in the F1 generation, is a character that is recessive character. So dominant one will appear in the F1 generation and recessive will get suppressed in the F1 generation. Each character is controlled by a pair of factors or genes, and when it is a pair of dissimilar factors, only one factor expresses. Thus one is dominant and the other is recessive. Even though they are present in the pairs, they are a pair of dissimilar factors or genes. Only one factor will express in the F1 generation, and the one which is expressed here is a dominant one, and another which is not expressed is a recessive one. The second law of segregation, or a second law of inheritance, says that members of allelic pair in a hybrid remain together, mixing without mixing with each other, and segregate during gamete formation. Thus gametes receive only one of the two factors and pure for a given trait. Therefore it is known as a law of purity of gametes. This law of segregation also can be explained with the monohybrid cross. The appearance of recessive trait in F2 proves this law. So what happens here, all sexually reproducing higher organisms are diploid, that is 2N, with two sets of chromosomes, and gametes which are haploid, N, that is with the one set of chromosomes, and therefore this law of segregation was universally applicable and acceptable. Now let's move to the next law, the law of independent assortment. It is a third law of inheritance. When two homozygous parents differing in two pairs of contrasting traits are crossed, the inheritance of one pair is independent of the other. In other words, when a dihybrid forms gametes, assortment or distribution of alleles of different traits is independent of their original combinations in the parents. This law can be explained with the help of dihybrid cross or dihybrid ratio. The appearance of new combinations in the generation proves this law. Now we know that many genes are located on one chromosome which are linked. These are linked genes and therefore they pass through gametes in the form of linkage groups. However, recombinations are due to the crossing over that takes place during meiosis. And these are gametes which are formed by meiotic process, meiotic division. And therefore, the law of independent assortment is applicable only for the traits which are located on different chromosomes. And therefore, the law of independent assortment is not that much universally applicable. So these are the three laws given by the Mendel's first law, second law, and third law. So if you understand this, these three laws of inheritance given by Mendel, please share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.